This week I've got one last Patreon-sponsored episode for you for a while, which comes courtesy of supporter James Hooks. Hooks has been a member of the online fandom since back in the 90s, and he was one of the fans whose screen names was used in the Beast Wars cartoon.
Rampage, position yourself in subsector Hooks.
In honor of the character who spoke his name, Hooks has picked the basics on Beast Wars Megatron. Like Generation 1 Megatron before him, the Megatron of Beast Wars was the leader of the series' enemy faction, the Predacons. When the Beast Wars toy line launched in 1996, he was available in two forms. A small alligator figure sold in a two-pack with the heroic Maximal leader Optimus Primal, and a huge Tyrannosaurus Rex. At first, Megatron and Optimus were treated as being the same characters from Generation 1, simply continuing their war in these new beast forms. But this changed when the Beast Wars cartoon took the story in a different direction. It reimagined the Maximals and Predacons as the descendants of the Autobots and Decepticons from hundreds of years in the future, and recast Megatron as a separate individual from the Generation 1 character who was a successor to his name. Megatron, the cartoon explained, wasn't his real name. In pursuit of grandeur, he'd renamed himself. Not after Generation 1 Megatron, as you might expect, but rather after a mythical figure who also shared the name, a great destroyer mentioned in the Transformer religious text, The Covenant of Primus. Unquestionably brilliant, Megatron was a master schemer who treated all who served him as pawns, a grandiloquent, dramatic deceiver and manipulator, but just as notable for his foibles, like his rubber ducky, and his tendency to end his sentences with an affected
"Yes,"
memorably delivered by voice actor David Kaye. As the Beast Wars cartoon began, Megatron and his criminal gang stole the Maximal relic known as the Golden Disc, using the information on it to travel back through time to prehistoric Earth. A crew of Maximals led by Optimus Primal pursued, and both factions wound up stranded on the planet, where they adopted organic-skinned alternate modes based on the local animals to protect their robot forms from the world's excessive energon radiation, with Megatron taking on the form of his T-Rex toy. Everyone believed that Megatron had come to Earth for its energon to fuel his overthrow of the Maximal rulers of Cybertron, but in reality, he was following a secret message left on the Golden Disc by Generation 1 Megatron, and had come back in time to kill Optimus Prime, altering history in the Decepticons' favor to ensure Predacon rule in the future. At first, Megatron was loath to take such a drastic step, and he spent the first two seasons of the show attempting to acquire other means of power that he hoped would be sufficient to conquer Cybertron instead, all the while contending with both the Maximals and his own scheming subordinates. It was in the second season that exposure to a quantum surge of alien energy mutated Megatron into the form of his new 1998 Transmetal action figure, which upgraded his dinosaur mode with flight capabilities. And it was in this form that he gave in and enacted his namesake's plan. His attempt to alter history was foiled, however, when Optimus Primal took Optimus Prime's spark into his body to protect it. Seeing the optimal power boost that the Maximal leader was granted by the process, Megatron replicated the effect on himself with Generation 1 Megatron's spark, mutating further into his new 1999 toy form, a fire and ice breathing Transmetal 2 Dragon. His new power wasn't enough to win the Beast Wars, however, and as the series came to a close, he was taken prisoner by the Maximals as they blasted off to return to their home time. Megatron's story continued directly into the sequel series Beast Machines. Breaking his bonds, Megatron escaped into the time stream and found himself back on Cybertron some time before Primal's team. Without his enemies to oppose him, Megatron used a paralyzing virus and an army of mindless Viacon drones to conquer the planet, harvesting the sparks of all its inhabitants. He had become obsessed with the idea of technological purity, determined to eradicate free will to bring cold, machine-like harmony to Cybertron, and found himself at odds with the returned Primal and his team, who sought to restore an organic balance to the planet. Megatron's new quest for purity encompassed a desire to rid himself of his own organic beast mode, but his attempts to do so backfired, trapping his spark in an entirely organic body without a robot mode, which instead changed from wolf to dragon. Using this new guise to pose as a Maximal named Noble, Megatron duped Primal's team into helping him transfer his spark into a new body, a colossal flying fortress known as the Grand Mal.
All three of these bodies were released in toy form, though the Grand Mile arrived belatedly as part of 2001's Robots in Disguise line.
But this wasn't the end of Megatron's body hopping. When he began absorbing all the captured sparks into his own, the Maximals stopped him by sealing his spark in a harmless diagnostic drone. But Megatron escaped to take on yet another new body, a replica of Optimus Primal's optimal form. In the series finale, he and Primal met in final battle and were both destroyed when Primal sent them plummeting into Cybertron's core. The end of the cartoons did not mark the end of Megatron, however. Numerous spin-off stories set within their continuity have continued his saga. Stories and toys from BotCon, the official Transformers convention, have detailed how, in his youth, he was mentored by, and eventually betrayed, the crime boss Cryotech. It was Cryotech who had orchestrated the theft of the Golden Disc, and who had invented the technology Megatron used to conquer Cybertron and Beast Machines. There were also plans to resurrect Megatron following his death at the end of Beast Machines in a new two-headed dragon body that would have been an exclusive toy for the 2005 convention. But the showrunners at the time, 3H Enterprises, lost the license before they were able to do so. The story was picked up in 2006 by the new license holders, Fun Publications, who changed things up to reveal that Megatron had instead been reborn in the form of a new toy released by Hasbro that year to celebrate Beast Wars' 10th anniversary. 10 years later, Fun Publications made the aborted exclusive a reality, but in their stories, it represented Megatron as he appeared many years before the Beast Wars instead of after. Megatron's also enjoyed several unique adventures in Japanese media, including a time travel trip into the Generation 1 cartoon era in 2004's Robot Masters toy line. Japan also had its own different 10th anniversary take on what became of him after Beast Machines. In this version of the story, told through the 2006 pro series Beast Wars Reborn, he and Optimus were brought back to life by Logos Prime, one of the original 13 Primes, who transported them into the world of the Unicron trilogy and had them compete to be the inheritors of his power over space and time. But not every new story starring Megatron is a spin-off from the cartoon. Take the comedy manga Transformers Legends, in which he and the rest of the Beast Wars cast are reimagined as office workers at rival companies. This cutesy super-deformed Megatron is president of Terracura Co., and in the course of the series, he's tried to win the affections of Black Arachnia, lost ownership of his company to Generation 1 Megatron, and been turned into a headmaster by Cobra Commander, receiving his own brand new toy in the process, based on the Generation 2 Megatron figure, complete with a new version of Noble. In the realm of more serious storytelling, there's Beast Wars Uprising. This series of Fun Publications Pro stories were the first to give Megatron a real name, Gnash Teeth, taken from a 2007 Minicon figure who looked a lot like him. In this alternate Beast Wars universe, where Maximals and Predacons were an impoverished underclass living under tyrannical Autobots and Decepticons, Gnash Teeth was the administrator of an Energon distillation plant. When classism led him to be passed over for a promotion, he broke bad and began embezzling the plant's Energon and selling it on the black market. This led to a run-in with the crime boss Thunderhoof, who gave Gnash Teeth the mocking nickname of Megatron for his imperious attitude, before beating him to within an inch of his life for horning in on his territory. Gnash Teeth took the name as a badge of honor, rechristening himself Megatron and building a criminal gang of his own, before revenge-killing Thunderhoof to become Cybertron's preeminent crime lord. Later in the Beast Wars Uprising story, Megatron funded the development of the Beast Upgrade, which gave Maximals and Predacons the ability to turn into animals. He was one of the first to undergo the upgrade, acquiring his two-headed dragon form. Most recently, Megatron has cameoed in IDW Publishing's comic books as one of Onyx Prime's Beast Army. It's probably too much to hope that he'll have a larger role in the series, but even then, he's never really left us. Megatron was voted by fans into the Transformers Hall of Fame in 2013, and David Kay has delivered an annual Christmas message from Megatron in character every year since 2011. Widely considered one of the all-time greatest villains in Transformers history, sooner or later his time will come again. Isn't that right, Megatron?
Yes.
And those are the basics on Beast Wars Megatron. Thanks to Hooks for sponsoring an episode about a much-loved character. Let me know if Megatron gets a yes or a no from you in the comments below. And don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more from the world of the Transformers.